Hello people, in this video let us look at disability indicators. So where are we? First of all, let us look at that. We are looking at health indicators. In health indicators, you have so many types of indicators, right? You have mortality indicators, morbidity indicators, then you also have disability indicators, which we are going to look at in this video. Okay, so here we are, disability rates. So what did we tell you? You have mortality indicators and morbidity indicators. So mortality will say that people are how much people are dying, etc. But it doesn't indicate that if a person is alive, is he healthy, right? So then you have the morbidity indicator, which can indicate disease, right? Ill health. But this, still the person may not be unhealthy or ill or diseased, but still he may be disabled, right? So that becomes yet another indicator of what? Health. So the person is alive, he is disease-free, but he could be disabled. So basically, mortality rates have not changed much, they are saying. So disability rate can indicate to you health, because health is not just being disease free, right? Health means that you are having a full range of daily activities. So what is health? Health is a state of being physically well, mentally well, social well-being. All the three things should be there. It's just not that you're disease free or free from infirmity, right? That is the definition of health. So disability rates are important. So guys, are you understanding why we are looking at disability rates? So now that you have understood why, let us look at the commonly used disability rates. So these are the disability rates. Actually, these are the disability rates, guys. Okay. But these can fall into two categories, either an event type indicator or a person type indicator. Event means what? A leave, a holiday, not a holiday, a leave. So the person is taking work loss days. So he's taking off work, right? Because of the disability, he's not able to go to work. So those would be work loss days. So events will be number of days of restricted activity. So all these are days you can remember. Restricted activity. Days of restricted activity. Bed disability days. So how many days this person is bedridden kind of thing. Or work loss days. Right? Everything has a day in it. At least that much you can remember. Day of restricted activity, bed disability day, work loss day. Okay? Or school loss day. Need not be just work. Okay? It can be a school loss day. Right? All these are disability indicator, event type indicators. Guys, this will be within a specified period that you should remember. Okay? Within specified period. Okay, so these are event type indicators. Now we are done with event type indicators. What is the other type of indicator? The other type of indicator is person type indicator. So the for the person, what exactly happened? Is he having limitation of mobility or is he having limitation of activity? Like limitation of mobility means he's confined to the bed, he's confined to the house, right? He's confined to the house or the bed. But what is limitation of activity? That means he can go out, right, or come, not exactly be in the bed, but basic activities of daily living, that is ADL, basic activities of daily living, he has limitation in performing these, limitation in performing activities of daily living. ADL means what, guys? Activities of daily living. So like what? What are these activities of daily living? Eating, washing, dressing, going to the toilet, moving about. Like he cannot work at his job or he cannot do housework. All those will become limitation of activity. But the person is able to go out, move kind of a thing, right? So did you understand what are the two main headings under which you can put these indicators? Event type indicator or a person type indicator. Now let us look at the actual indicators. Hale, Qualy, DFLE, DALY. Let's put this in a different slide. What are we looking at? Disability indicators. Okay. So guys, we are going to the indicators of disability now. Hale. See, look at this main thing. H-A-L-E, right? This is L-E ending. Okay. This is also L-E ending. These are life expectancy. What is L-Y? L-Y is the years. Okay. Life years, like that you can remember. So you have Qualy and DALY. Let's put this here. What do you say? Qualy and DALY, Hale and DFLE. All these are life expectancy. These two are life years. Let's look at what HALE is. Health adjusted life expectancy. What is this? Health adjusted life expectancy. We already told you that LE is life expectancy, correct? So what is this? Health adjusted life expectancy. You know what life expectancy is. So how long, can this person live? As an average, you know that life expectancy. What is life expectancy? Currently, what is life expectancy in India? See, life expectancy at birth currently for India, or longevity index in longevity netting, 69.4, okay, 69.4 years the person can live. So remember, currently this value is life expectancy at birth, 69.4. So this is health adjusted life expectancy. Similarly, this one is disability adjusted life expectancy. Guys, did you understand? There's a health adjusted life expectancy and disability adjusted life expectancy. So you will live probably 100 years. But what is the amount of time that you will be disabled that they want to subtract from life expectancy? So this will be something like life expectancy minus the disability period. Disability period. Okay. So similarly, what is this health adjusted life expectancy? Life expectancy adjusted for poor health. So this is more like the equivalent number of years in full health that a newborn can expect to live based on current rates of ill health and mortality. So they are subtracting the poor health, something like that. Okay, they are adjusting, just remember, they are adjusting the life expectancy to poor health. So how many years can the, how many years can the newborn be expected to live based on the current rates of ill health and mortality? Guess, is it going above your head? So let us move on to the next one then. Where are we here? So when you have DFLE, DFLE is disability free life expectancy. Disability free life expectancy. So it is the DFLE or the Sullivan index, if I'm not wrong. This is also called as active life expectancy. Okay. This is the average number of years an individual is expected to live free of disability if current pattern of mortality and disability continue to apply. So they're just, you can say the life expectancy is adjusted to the disability. Okay. So did you understand these two life expectancies, guys? Now let us move on to the life years, QALY-DALY. What is this? QALY. QALY is quality adjusted life years. And what is this one? Disability adjusted life years. Is it pretty clear, or we should understand this? Quality adjusted life years. Guys, how's it going? What have we looked at so far? HALE and DFLE we have looked at. DFLE. This we have looked at. Now let us move on to QALY and DALY. What are all these, guys? These all are disability indicators. So let's move on to QALY. Quality adjusted life years. It's a measure of the disease burden. So both the quality and quantity of the life lived. So whatever you live, you should live a quality life, right? That's what they want. Here, they are talking about what improvement, okay? So it's more like an improvement kind of a thing. Quality adjusted life years. The number of years of life that would be added by intervention. So by intervening, how much more years can we give for you? Right? Something like that. So here they are talking about quality and quantity looks like. So if you live 1 year of quality, you know, perfect health, then you will get one. Okay. Each year in perfect health is assigned a value of one. Okay. 1.0 they are saying actually. And if the person dies, then it will be 0.0. So there's some calculation here. There is something called as one QALY. One QALY is 1 year of life into one utility value. So 1 into 1 is 1. Okay. Then what is the difference then? This is one QALY. So this is, they have lived in perfect health in 1 year. Then what is? In case they have lived perfect, half of the year is lived in perfect health. Okay. So then they have 0.5 QALY if half of the year they had perfect health. दिस ईयर आर यू हाफ क्वाली और वन क्वाली, यू डिसाइड. व्हेन डिसम्बर कम्स यू डिसाइड दिस ईयर वेदर यू लिव्ड अ क्वालिटी और नॉट, एंड बेस्ड ऑन दैट यू गिव योरसेल्फ वन क्वाली और हाफ क्वाली. ओके गाइस, डिड यू अंडरस्टैंड? इट्स काइंड ऑफ वियर्ड, राइट, दिस कैलकुलेशन. या क्वाली वी आर डन विद, क्वालिटी adjusted life years. They're saying mainly it is the number of years of life that would be added by intervention. That is what they said, but they have some calculations here. Okay, DALY, D-A-L-Y, disability adjusted life years. Guys, this DALY little became dark, okay. Basically, they are saying it is the number of years lost due to ill health, disability or early death. This is disability adjusted life years, but this is something kind of a negative feeling it is giving me. It is saying that it is the number of years lost, okay, due to ill health, disability or early death. So in this, they're saying this, they are using a lot nowadays, disability adjusted life years. So here they have YLL, YLD, and this DALY is equal to YLL plus YLD. Now what is this YLL? YLL is years of lost life. So number of deaths of each age multiplied by the expected remaining years of life. So if you are expected to live for 69 something, 70 years you are expected to live, right? That is life expectancy. But you lived only, let's say 50. Then 20 is the years of life lost, something like that. What is YLD? Years lost to disability. So years that you lost to disability, so the average duration of the disease, etc., etc., they're taking the years that you lost to disability. So let us say you died at 50, yes, so you lost 20. And then 40 years the person got disabled, so 10 years went in disability. So here you will have 20 plus 10, so totally 30 years this person lost. That will become disability adjusted life years. Number of years lost due to ill health, disability or early death. That is how much the person lost. In this case, ill health he lost, because of disability he lost 10 years, and then he because of ill health he died 20 years early than life expectancy, so 30 years. So DALY is disability adjusted life years, the number of years lost due to ill health, disability and early death. Okay. DALY is equal to YLL plus YLD. They seem to like this DALY a lot, guys. They are saying that this is the most appropriate measure for the effects of chronic illnesses and all that. Guys, like we told you, they like this DALY a lot. What do they like? DALY, DALY. What is DALY? Disability adjusted life years, right? Yes. So they are saying it's the most appropriate measure of chronic illness, and they are saying that the psychiatric and neurological causes account for many years lived in disability. Okay, in disability, neurological conditions, psychiatric conditions they are blaming. Okay, but it accounts for less of deaths. Deaths is not because of this, but disability is mainly because of this. That is what they seem to be giving me an impression here. So the percentage of death due to this may be less, but they have a huge impact on the population. And young adults, you know, the years lived as a young adult is valued more than what you spend as a older adult. So the value of your young adult years are more, guys. So now we are done with disability indicators. Let's take a recap. Disability indicators are important because mortality and morbidity don't give you the full picture, okay? Mortality and morbidity rates don't give full picture, right? You don't get picture of disability. So you need disability rates. So there are disability indicators can be event type indicator or a person type indicator. Event type indicator means day. Remember, days of restricted activity, bed disability day, school loss, work loss or school loss day, you have to remember. Person means they can have limitation of mobility, that is they are confined to the house or bed. Limitation of activity means they can move around, but they have limitation in performing their activities of daily living or their work, right? So that becomes person type indicator. So what are actual indicators? You have HALE, HALE, health adjusted life expectancy, DFLEs, that is disability free life expectancy, QALY, quality adjusted life years, and DALY, that is disability adjusted life years. Basically, LELE is life year expectancy, LYLY is life years. Now, what is health adjusted life expectancy? You take the life expectancy and remove the poor health part of it, so it becomes health adjusted life expectancy. DFLE is a disability-free life expectancy and is also called as Sullivan's index looks like. It is also active life expectancy. So your life expectancy minus the disability will give you the disability-free life expectancy. Now what is QALY? Quality adjusted life years. This is something very unusual and it has some calculation and all. It is the amount of that you can extend by intervention, you know, amount of years extra you can give to the person by intervention, interestingly. And one quali is 1 year that you have lived a quality life, that becomes one quali. Okay. Half quali means only half year you lived a quality life. Did you understand that, guys? So that is quali. Half quali, one quali. Half quali means you lived only half the year with good quality life. Then coming to disability adjusted life years, this is something bad. You're saying the amount of years that you lost due to disability or ill health because of early death. So you have life, years of life lost is YLL. That means if the person died early, so based on the life expectancy, how many more years lives you could have lived. So those years are the life, years that the person lost, that is YLL. Years lost to disability is YLD. So you're living, but you're not living fully. So you have disability means YLD, years lost to disability. So DALY, DALY is the years lost, total years lost. So it will be YLL plus YLD. It is the most appropriate measure of chronic illnesses, they are saying. And they're just saying, understand that psychiatric and neurological causes can lead to disability. Not exactly death, but disability. So it is a very important indicator. That's what they're saying. So we have seen in this video all the disability rates. So disability rate is one of the health indicators, remember. So here we have covered this one, disability rates. I think this should be more like a red, disability rates, okay? So it's an indicator of health. That's all for now, guys, in this video. We'll meet you in the next one. Bye-bye.